Tufaa ama apple ni tunda moja maarufu duniani ambalo hupendwa kuliwa na watu wa jamii zote. Hii inatokana na utamu wake pamoja na faida za kiafya zinazopatikana kwa kula matufaa. Matunda haya hustawi zaidi kwenye nyanda za juu ambako joto sio kali. Kenya ina upungufu wa matufaa, kwani kwa mwaka hununua zaidi ya tani 10,000 za matunda haya kutoka nje. Mataifa yanayoyapanda kwa wingi ni kama vile China, ambayo inaongoza kwa karibu tani milioni 37. Inafuatwa na Marekani inayozalisha tani milioni 4.11 na Uturuki tani milioni 2.88. Nchi zingine katika orodha hii ni Poland tani milioni 2.87, India tani milioni 2.20, Italia tani 1.99 na Brazil tani 1.81. Barani Afrika, mataifa yanayokuza matunda haya kwa wingi ni Misri, Morocco, Afrika Kusini, Tunisia na Nigeria. Kenya ni taifa lililojaliwa kwa rasilimali nyingi, kuanzia mchanga wenye rutuba hadi maji, hivyo basi sekta ya kilimo ni rahisi kufanikisha. Upungufu wa matunda haya unaoshuhudiwa unaweza ukawa historia endapo wakulima watakumbatia matufaa, kwa kuwa hayana kazi kuyapanda na kutunza. Daktari Onesmus ni mkulima tajika wa matufaa nchini, anayejishughulisha na ukuzaji na upanzi wa miche za matufaa katika eneo la Kipkenyo viungani mwa mji wa Eldoret kwenye kaunti ya Uasin Gishu. Anaelezea jinsi miche ya apples hukuzwa hadi kuzaa matunda na kuuzwa sokoni. Je, ungependa kufahamu mengi kuhusu kilimo cha apples? Twende shambani. Kawaida tumetembea milima na mabonde hadi katika maeneo ya Kipkenyo kwenye kaunti ya Uasin Gishu, ambapo leo hii tunaangazia kilimo cha matufaa, ukipenda apples katika lugha ya Kiingereza. Na hivi sasa tutaungana naye mkulima wetu ambaye atatujuza mengi kuhusiana na jinsi miche ya matufaa inavyokuzwa pale shambani na vile vile inavyolindwa hadi kuwa mti mkubwa kama huu na kuanza kuzaa matufaa, jinsi imeweza kuzaa kwenye shamba hili la Kipkenyo. Kwa hivyo mtazamaji, ungana nami kuanzia sasa hadi tamati unufaike na mengi kutokana na kipindi hiki cha Ajira Shambani. Hii ni Sayare TV na leo niko na mkulima Daktari Onesmus ambaye atuelekeza kuhusiana na mchakato mzima wa ukuzaji wa matufaa, ukipenda apples. Vile vile atakuwa anaangazia ukulima kwa ujumla wa apples na manufaa ya apples. Je, kama kuna soko ya apples ama hamuna? Na je, mkulima anaweza anzisha ukulima hiki cha upanzi wa matufaa? Mbona ukaamua na kilimo cha apples?
Sasa mwasikia, mimi naitwa Dr. Onesmus Ngatish na mimi ni proprietor wa Eldoret Orchards and Nursery. Katika Eldoret Orchards and Nursery tunafanya ukuzaji wa aina nyingi za mimea. Moja wapo ni tofaa, vile umesema kwa Kiswahili, matofaa. Apples ni hapo ni mmea ambaye umea kwa urahisi, na tuli weza kuchagua hii kwa sababu most of the time we import from outside and the conditions here are actually favorable for production of warm climate apples. Kitambo kidogo watu walikuwa wanafikiria apples ni kutoka Egypt, kutoka South Africa, kutoka Pakistan. Lakini hiyo ideology ndio tunajaribu kuitoa kwa sababu tunaamini kuwa inamea vizuri, inatoa matunda vizuri kama unaielewa. Kwa sababu hii mani ni unaweza kuiguza kama unaielewa, lakini kama hauielewi yafaa kwanza upate mafunzo kidogo, kwa sababu kuna vitu tunaita physiological responses, cultural practices, and also understanding the soils, understanding the soils nutritional status and how it influences growth. Alafu pia lazima uelewe ni ni farati gani ambayo inafanya vizuri katika sehemu hii yetu. Kuna farati ambayo tunaita it requires very cold conditions, high chilling requirements, and the others that requires less chilling requirements. Those are the temperatures where you know plants need for it to flower.
Daktari, kuzungumzia kuhusiana na mazingira. Hapa ni county ya Uasin Gishu. Je, ni apples matufaa aina gani ambayo ina uwezo kukua vyema katika maeneo haya?
So katika hii shamba letu tulifanya experiment tukianza mwaka wa 2018 na varieties karibu nane. Moja wapo ni Braeburn, tuko na Ana, wengine huita Ombugu. It's called Ana. They call it Ombugu. It is really I don't know what to mention about it, but it's called Ana. We have Fuji, which is this one.
Okay.
Fuji native to Japan. Ana is native to Israel, and it was released in 1957 for first commercialization by farmers in warm climate areas. Tuko na Royal Gala, huwa inaguswa Italy, the US, Australia, and the like. Royal Gala, that is a really very good variety for those people who has a kiungulia acidic acidity, because it doesn't have a lot of acids.
Okay.
We have a Golden Desert, which is also warm climate apples, native to Israel. We have winter banana, which is a pollinator for Braeburn and Royal Gala. We have eight.
A pink lady.
We have pink lady is not found in Kenya. Those are, I mean, those we haven't gotten the scion, the germ plasm to really propagate here, but many people will sell any red apple as a pink lady, because it's in our mind pink lady is maybe the best. There are about 8 varieties that we've done here. So okay, the best one that we, after evaluating, the best variety that we have found is Anna, Golden Desert, and Braeburn. That is in area in Uasin Gishu region. If you do Fuji, they tend to be affected by the blight,
okay.
Fire blight, and then Royal Gala, they don't flower because they require very high chilling requirement. But they do well in a low altitude where if you withhold water. It represents high chilling requirements, hence it will flower. Flowering is only affected by stress, not induced by stress, not really cold climate only. And then we have Granny Smith that I forgot. It's a tip bearer, and it's also difficult for it to flower here. We are doing some experiments in Kerio Valley to see so that we can be able to understand whether it will flower efficiently, like Braeburn on this end.
Ukiangazia mchakato mzima wa upanzi wa matufaa, je, mkulima anapaswa kuanzia wapi?
Kwanza kabisa mkulima anafaa kuelewa aina ya mmea. Information ni mingi, anaweza pata kwanza kufanya YouTube. You get a lot of knowledge from YouTube. Then if you want to start your own production unit, say from one point of an acre or 400 meters square, we always advise our clients to visit us here because our role is to enthuse them and to really show them what they need to do to plant. We do production of seedlings, and that is our business. So we normally advise clients depending on the spacing on the area, surface area they have, we can give them the right spacing, and then we'll sell the seedlings for them. Here we specialize in production of seedlings, and the kind of seedlings we produce are very quality seedlings, because we don't use lockwort as a rootstock. If you go on the streets, you find, because they are lockwort and apple belong to the same family, when you graft they form a union, but it doesn't influence yields, it doesn't influence growth. There is what we call a rootstock, and that's why we say it's a grafted plant. A grafted plant has a rootstock and the sound.
mchakato mzima wa upanzi wa miche ni gani?
Asante sana kwa what I will explain is that this is a whole process of planting.
Mm.
That starts from getting the seedlings from the orchards. We'll give you the dimensions, the spacing of maybe 3x3, 4x3, depending on your preference. Then in the process of planting entails digging a standard hole of 2 feet by 2 feet by 2 feet. Get 1 dB of manure, mix with the hole is a standard hole. You can, the bigger the better, because it will ensure that there's efficient proliferation of roots, which actually translates to increase in growth. Then you mix the soil, mostly the topsoil and the manure, and backfill. Then thereafter, you remove the polythene from the seedling, shake it a little bit for the roots to be exposed, and then you do plant your tree. Put a stake to hold the plant in the right place, and then leave it for 2 months. Then after, you can come with some fertilizers like Fanisi planting with both macro and micro elements. You add a little bit, maybe 20 grams after every other 1 month, of course, while doing irrigation when need be. If it's the rainy season, well and good. But ensure that when you add some fertilizers, inorganic fertilizers, apply water. Then leave the plant to grow. After 6 months, like, tip the plant at 670 centimeters, allow it to produce as many branches as it can, leave it for up to 10 months, and then come in with your secateur, remove the branches that are weak, leave the strong ones, and do start the bending from the lower end.
Ukizungumzia kuhusu mbolea, fertilizer, wewe kama mtaalamu wa kilimo, ungependa kupatia wasia mtazamaji aweze kutumia inorganic fertilizer ama organic fertilizer?
We do integrated application of fertilizers. Tumia yote. Organic fertilizer during planting, and maybe every other year you apply at least some organic, hiyo ni manure ya mbuzi, kondoo, ngombe. That is what we do prefer, only because of the advantages associated with organic fertilizers. And then again, for immediate use, you know, organic fertilizers do not provide nutrients immediately for plant uptake. It provides slowly over a longer period of time. But if you want to boost growth, you bring in inorganic. And also to correct deficiencies, inorganic does very well. So both nutrients are good and should be applied in integrated mode. Then, if I can proceed with the process,
yes.
Then thereafter, you successfully do the bending to cover the allocated space for the plant while protecting the plant against mites. That's a process that you do after every other 2 weeks, and during the dry period, you spray miticides, things like Nocbectin, Abamectin. You spray insecticides like Thunder, Marshall. Those are the ones that controls both mites and insects. You also protect against the fungal infections like fire blight, mostly fire blight. And once in every 2 weeks, or during the dry period, once in a month or so. And then leave the continuously. You need to apply water during the dry period, because that is very important for growth. If you want your plant to come into production fully during the third year, application of water or irrigation is inevitable.
Ukizungumzia kuhusu magonjwa kama vile fungal na blight, unapaswa kupiga dawa mimea yako baada ya muda gani?
Baada ya muda 2 weeks. Machuma mawili.
Kila baada ya wiki mbili.
Yeah, during the rainy season. But during the dry season, fungal infections are not an issue. It's simple. You just do once in a month, or even once after every 2 months. If there are no fungal infection on your plants, there's no point of doing what? Of spending on chemicals.
Okay.
We use chemicals like Score, Absolute, Milras, Ridomil. Those are broad spectrum, and even Otifa. Those are broad spectrum fungicides. But again, you need to observe. During harvesting, we don't apply, a month or one and a half months before harvesting, don't apply chemicals. You leave it that way.
Shaka, hii ni Sayare TV na hiki ni kipindi cha Ajira Shambani. Bado tuko naye Daktari Onesmus kwenye shamba lake hapa maeneo ya Kipkenyo ambako anakuza miche vile vile matunda ya matufaa. Matufaa ambayo imefanywa grafting ama pandikizi katika lugha ya Kiswahili. Inachukua muda gani kuweza kukua na kukomaa kabla ya kupeleka sokoni?
Yeah, I mentioned it earlier. It's a function of many things. The standard way, the commercial yield comes in the third year. Commercial yield is when you get substantive number of fruits, maybe 200 and above fruits per tree. Then the third year is the best. You can start in the middle of the second year to have a sizable number of fruits, maybe 100 fruits, and you can still sell. Depending on the number of plants you have, if you have 1,000 plants, you have maybe 200 or 100 fruits per tree in the second year, times 1,000, that is a good number of fruits. You can still get into the market as a commercial yield. But again, this depends on whether you are a farmer who adheres to production process of administering the standard agronomic practices. If you don't follow the standard agronomic practices, be sure that even coming to the third year, in Esakwa ni Maua, it's not producing. And that applies to many other crops.
Mche ama mti wa matufaa inachukua muda gani kabla uja ukata? Ama inazaa milele?
Oh, okay. The productive life of the plant, 40 years. The productive life is 40 years. Okay. That is according to the literature. Some plant people, or the traditionalists, people who are farming traditionally can leave it for a while, or you do the pruning, and then they do the, it's called rejuvenative pruning. But the standard productive life is should be not more than 40 years.
Okay. Mtu mmoja wa matufaa ambayo imekomaa inazaa matunda ngapi kwa mwaka?
Ni swali poa. What happens is that if you are doing high density production system like what we are doing here, we expect at least 300 fruits, and we maintain at that. The moment you allow it to do more, then they reduce in size. The quality of the fruits are not really the right size. But again, if you do a spacing of 5x5 or 4x4, you leave the plant to grow big, right? It can give you up to 500, 600 marketable yield. But again, it has a challenge because any fruit that is not well exposed to the sun does not develop the anthocyanins, this red color, right? Any fruit that is not exposed to the sunlight is very important for the development of color. That is very key. for the conversion of chlorophyll to chromoplast. Light is very important. So if you do a bigger plant, the fruits that will be produced inside the bush of the tree, hence will not give that color. So the quality in the market also might not be the preferred. So that is why we do small fruits, small plants. We do windows on the plant through pruning to allow efficient penetration of light to all the fruits that are in within the tree bush to be able to produce, to attain that color during the ripening period.
Virutubishi ndani ya apples ni gani ambayo inasaidia sana aswa kufukuza magonjwa ndani ya miili ya binadamu?
Of course it has a lot of vitamins, a lot of antioxidants and minerals that really is good for human health. Yeah, I mean vitamins, madini or minerals that are also helpful in your day-to-day nutrition. But again, they say it doesn't keep the dentist away because it mineralizes the enamel, hence making it thin. Hence increasing teeth sensitivity. So there are also those challenges. So you need to know the type of variety you want. Of course, you ensure that you get a ripe fruit with minimal or well less acidity. You know, the process of ripening entails reduction of acids or conversion of acid to sugars. Acids are carbon, it's also a carbon component, so it converts acids to simple sugars, which limits the effect of acids on teeth. But again, sugars are also not good for, so it's there's an argument there. But again, apples are very good for your health.
Wengi wanasema kwamba tufaa lenye rangi ya kijani kibichi, yani green, ni nzuri sana kuweza kuzuia magonjwa kama vile cancer. Je, ni kweli?
Yeah, because it has a lot of antioxidants, vitamins. It's loaded with vitamins then. Just like guava. You know, guava, if I'm digress a little bit, mapera has 3 times higher vitamins than apple. Yeah, so you can even do the Googling there. So guava is even much better than apple. Many people don't know that. It is actually it's the only fruit with high levels of vitamin A. Apples do not have vitamin A. They are very, very small quantities, but the other one has 28% than an apple. So the green apple is loaded with more of vitamins. That is why it's not sweet. It's more acidic. And that's why many people are being told, go and buy the green apple. It's called Granny Smith. We only do propagation by order because it's not really preferred by many. Kenyans love the red stuff and sweet stuff.
Naona kwamba umepanda miche mingi zaidi ni kwa ajili ya kuuza. Unaweza mwambia mkulima ni kwa nini aanzishe kilimo cha ukuzaji matufaa?
Of course, if you are that guy who loves to be independent financially and have your own money to spend and run away from fearing to spend, invest in apple, because you get an acre of apple will give you money. At least even the third year, if you follow the standard production practices, the third year you might get some, not less than, some few meters. So it based on the calculation that we've done, you can see it has money. So if you want to generate income, not as a hobby, then you can venture into apple production. The market is there also. I mean, and you don't shout too much. The moment they know you have apples, they come and take from at farm gate. People are asking me do the supplies, and you know we don't have the enough quantities to supply. If you produce apples during June, July, August, you sell at 30 shillings a piece. Because in the market, it's 40 shillings. So if you sell 30 shillings a piece and you have 300 per plant, or even 200 per plant, that's 6,000 shillings. 6,000 times 1,000 plants, that is good money for somebody who wants to venture into apple production. I have some few farmers who are now, I'm following them up on the, and giving them advice on the process of production. Free. If you do buy my seedlings, you only fuel my car. I come to your farm, but it has to be a sizable sizable numbers, because I mean it has to justify my time also. So I, that step by step guidance is there.
No, 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 who's a
meeting? Then, sorry. Yeah. If you take some few plants, you visit here for free advice. Okay. Still, I don't charge the consultant. If you buy seedlings elsewhere and you want my seedlings, I give you an invoice on just the knowledge.
Okay.
Yeah.
Pengine tuambie kwa sasa uko na seedlings kiasi gani kwenye shamba lako hapa na unauza kwa shilingi ngapi? Japo ulikuwa umeelezea pale awali kwa yule ambaye ilikuwa imempita.
The minimum price is 1000 shillings. Whether it's a bigger plant or a smaller plant, we sell it at 1000 shillings. 1000 shillings. We have thousands of seedlings. We have thousands of seedlings. You place your order, you get your we produce them in a separate nursery from here. Where we display our products is a different place than from the production site. Yeah.
All right.
I'll take you there right now so that you take some photos of the seedlings.
All right. Bila shaka mtazamaji, ni kipindi cha Ajira Shambani na hii ni Sayare TV. Naitwa Paul Kibora, niko na mkulima daktari Onesmus ambaye anatuelezea mengi kuhusiana na ukuzaji, mchakato mzima wa ukuzaji wa matufaa ukipenda apples. Pengine tukimalizia daktari, changamoto kuu hasa katika ukuzaji mzima wa matufaa ni gani ambayo mkulima akwe tayari kukumbana nayo?
Maji, water. You, before investing in production of apples, lazima ukuwe na maji, sufficient amount of water. That is the only thing you need to have. If you have sufficient amount of water and you follow our production guidelines, you are good to go.
Jambo la mwisho ungependa kumwambia je mkulima?
Karibuni sana Eldoret Orchards. We have enough seedlings for you. Visit, this is the planting season. You are all welcome. Thank you.
Asante sana. Huyu amekuwa ni daktari Onesmus Sangetich ambaye anajihusisha na kilimo cha matufaa kwenye shamba lake hapa, na vile vile kuna matunda mengi ambayo pia anajihusisha nayo katika shamba lake hapa maeneo ya Kipkenyo. Kwa hivyo ukitaka kufahamu mengi, tembelea shamba lake maeneo ya Kipkenyo ili uweze kujifunza mengi kuhusiana na kilimo cha matufaa. Bila shaka ni kilimo cha apples. Ningependa kuonja kwa niaba ya wenzangu ambao wamekuwa pale.
Enjoy.
Naomba tukula pamoja. Kufikia hapo, nimetimisha kipindi hiki cha Ajira Shambani. Hadi wiki ijayo, sana siku kama ya leo, na kutakia usiku mwanana.